come join us here at the CabaRay.
That's the Ray Stevens CabaRay and Showroom right here in West Nashville. We're easy to find at the Charlotte Avenue exit off I-40 West. It's the place in Nashville for a special entertainment and dining experience. There's great food, all your favorite wines and mixed drinks, a fun piano bar where you can sing along and dance. And there's the Ray Stevens Show, where I'll sing all my biggest hits with Nashville's best musicians and singers. So whether it's a special date night, entertaining friends and family, or you're just coming out to sing along in the piano bar, whatever your reason, the CabaRay is a fun place to enjoy a full night of entertainment. And the parking is free. So come see me, Ray Stevens, at the CabaRay. Call 615-327-4630 or go to raystevenscabaret.com. Make your plans now.
And now, from the Ray Stevens Studios in the heart of Music Row in Music City, USA, it's Ray Stevens' CabaRay Nashville.
I keep going back to Nashville. That's the only place for me. My love is waiting there in Nashville. Nashville, Tennessee.
With Ray's guest, Lari White. A-team. One more time, it's time for Ray Stevens.
Unforgettable, that's what you are. Unforgettable, though near or far, like a song of love that clings to me, how the thought of you does things to me never before. That's why, darling, it's incredible that someone so unforgettable thinks that I am unforgettable. Solely, everybody. Yes, and that's why, darling, it's incredible that someone so unforgettable thinks that I am unforgettable too. Please, won't you think that I am unforgettable too?
Welcome to our CabaRay Nashville. We've got an unforgettable guest and an unforgettable show for you this time. So let's go over to the little red piano and get things started. Our guest is a beautiful woman who sings on records, acts in major motion pictures, and produces award-winning CDs for the likes of Toby Keith and others. Let's make welcome the beautiful and talented Lari White.
Thank you so much, honey. I will. Hi.
It's a pleasure to have you here. I sent you a FedEx package a few years ago, and I'm wondering if you ever got it. Did they deliver that?
You know what's really funny? I got that part in the movie Castaway because a generous FedEx truck driver turned around. I literally had my audition tape in my hand at 11:05. I'm pulling up to the downtown FedEx box, which was the last FedEx pickup, and their director wanted to have my audition tape the next day.
Yeah.
So I pulled up. I'm literally leaning out the window of my car with the tape going, wait, wait, wait. He stopped and he pulled around, and as he pulled up next to my car, he goes, you're Lari White. And I said, yes, I'm Lari White. And this is an audition for a Tom Hanks movie. And if you will take this and get it to the director by tomorrow, if I get this part, you will be my hero forever. So I signed his notebook, and then he took the tape, and it landed, and rest is history.
Oh,
so
yeah.
Isn't that funny that I owed that part to a FedEx driver?
Yeah.
Love FedEx. FedEx
that's
rocks.
That's a great story. You know, where was all that shot, the part of the movie you were in? It looks like Kansas or Nebraska or someplace like that.
I know we flew into Amarillo, Texas, and then we drove a long way. So It was kind of south of nowhere.
It could have been Kansas or Nebraska.
It really was in the middle of, and it was on this family's farm. You know that truck that I got to drive, that really cool old, that was actually the truck of the grandfather of the family that owned that farm. They didn't rent that truck. It wasn't something they found through, you know, set design or something. That was grandpa's truck.
That's great.
Yeah, it was pretty cool. Yeah. You want to know the best story that I have about Castaway yet, though?
Yes.
That wasn't the original ending that you saw in the film. Don't you want to know what really happened?
Oh, yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So, you know, at the end, so he's been on an island by himself for 3.5 years. Poor guy. So he finally gets home. His fiance is now married with somebody else and has a child. And, you know, so, but he's carried that FedEx box the entire time, right? And he goes to deliver it to the address, but nobody's home, so he leaves it there. And then this woman pulls up in the truck and gives him directions, and that's me. And then she drives off. And then the last thing you see in the theater is just, you know, Tom Hanks with that cute little grin that he does, and that's it. And then the credits roll. But there was one more shot that we shot originally, and it had him getting back in his Jeep, and he kind of drove around the crossroads a few times. And then the camera was on that big crane. And as he's pulling down the road, the camera starts pulling out, pulling out, pulling out, until you see that he is, in fact, hauling butt after her truck as fast as he can, following her back to her, because he's seen the angel wings on her license plate. So in the original ending, of course, they end up together. But the writer told me that when they screened it for the big audiences, the test audiences, you know, that they do, that the women in the test audience thought it was too soon for him to be chasing after another woman.
3.5 years is too soon?
Too soon. He hadn't suffered enough, Ray.
Oh, me. I tell you, I'm sorry. I think they should have used that ending.
So they took out that very last shot.
Wow.
And just had it up to your imagination.
Well, it's amazing what you can learn watching Ray Stevens CabaRay Nashville, isn't it? Oh, yeah, what an education. Wow.
Now you know the rest of the story.
Yes. Yeah. So you're from Florida, right?
I am. I'm a cracker. My parents, my grandparents, way, 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 so many generations back, we can't even.
One of our A-team singers, one of the Huzzies, Sabrina, is from Florida, too.
Sabrina, girl, where are you from?
I'm from Sneeds, Florida.
Sneeds? My mother's from Vernon, and my father's from Sop Choppy.
Oh, then we're like cousins.
Yeah, we are. Yeah, we're all related across there.
Sneeds
yeah.
is up there near Vernon.
It's a lot of intermarrying up there. Yeah.
When you know my husband's mother's from Wasissa. And my dad's from Wakulla County, and they're neighboring counties. So when Chuck and I first went down to Tallahassee to visit family for the very first time when we first started dating, we're visiting his Aunt Joy. And Joy says, "Well, honey, do you know Sharon White?" And I said, "Well, that Aunt Sharon, that's my dad's baby sister." And she said, "Well, honey, your Aunt Sharon and I worked in the Capitol together for 15 years. I did my best to get your Aunt Sharon to go out with Chuck's Uncle Charles, and she wouldn't do it." And so then we stopped asking questions. But the kids have turned out okay. So.
And all you folks wind up in Music City from places like that. Why don't you do a song for us then? Let me walk you out to the red carpet, and will you sing a song for us?
I would love to sing a song. And I get to do it on the red carpet.
This is fancy.
Well, we with the red piano and the red carpet.
We couldn't afford a big one, but at least it's red. Ladies and gentlemen, Lari White.
Now, this is a song that every word of this song is autobiographically true. I wrote this song about my boyfriend at the time, who was a songwriter and had real long hair, and he was from Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, and he talked real slow. When I took him home to meet my parents, it was not pretty at first. But, you know, we've been married for 22 years now. We got three kids, and he's had a bunch of big old hits now as a songwriter, Chuck Cannon. But you know what stands behind every successful songwriter? An astonished mother-in-law. That boy walking down the street thinks he's tough, but he smiles so sweet. Snakeskin boots and a baseball cap. Bet you'd like to meet a boy like that. He's a little crazy, he's a little loud. He loves to do what ain't allowed. He might talk too slow and drive too fast. He'd do any little thing I'd ask. Oh, that's my baby, yeah. That's my baby. That's my diamond in the rough. And I make him shine with my sweet love. That's my baby.
That's my baby.
That's my baby. He's a rebel, wild, free. And my mama says he ain't no good for me. Oh, and my daddy prays he's just a phase I'm going through. But one of these days they're gonna love him too. 'Cause that's my baby. Yeah.
Fabulous. Hi, this is Ray Stevens with some great news. My CabaRay gift shop has gone digital. You no longer have to drive to Tennessee to see all the stuff we have for you to enjoy and buy. Take your time and take a nice long look around at all the ball caps, t-shirts, monkeys and squirrels. We have keychains, cups, mouse pads, and books, CDs, DVDs, and so much more. Everything we have in the gift shop is now available to you here online. So fill up that shopping cart. I'd love to hear you sing another song or two if you have time.
I'd love to sing another song. You want to hear a new song?
Yeah.
This is tailor-made for like Ray Stevens CabaRay
Well, let's give
world.
It a shot.
So, okay, this is
a new
one.
Ladies and gentlemen, Lari White.
I'd like to play one of the new loves songs for you. You want to hear a song you've never heard before? And as they say in Monty Python, now for something totally different. I spent some time in New York in the last few years. I got to be in a Broadway show. I got to originate a role, actually, in the Johnny Cash musical Ring of Fire, which was, yes, thank you. It was a blast. It was just like a parallel universe of you can imagine, you know, growing up as a country girl and then living in New York City for a year. But it turns out I loved it. I didn't expect it, but I fell in love with New York and fell in love with a whole new world of music, the American songbook. Cole Porter and Gershwin, and ended up writing some songs, and this is one of the songs that came out of that. I'm picturing Julie London, 1957, you know, the long, tight black gown and the white gloves that come up above the elbow and that long cigarette thing. I don't even smoke, but that just looks so cool. So go there with me for a minute. A lady never touches whiskey or tequila, no matter how refined. There's only one thing that she can turn to drown her broken heart and clear her mind. Champagne. When life gets troubly, champagne. A little bubbly in a tall glass with a long stem, enough to make you forget about him. Champagne, so pale and pretty. You're not thinking when you're drinking champagne. Wickedly sophisticated, you can hide your with a smile, elegantly in need. So pour another champagne to absent lovers. Let the band play on more Dom Perignon till you're too far gone to feel the pain. Let it rain. Let it Thank you so much.
Oh, that was wonderful. It was great to have you on the show. Lari White, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you. Thanks for that red piano.
Once again, Ray Stevens.
Jesus through the goalpost of life, in and over and through those righteous uprights, straight through the heart, neither left nor to right. Dropkick me, Jesus, through the goalpost of life. Make me, oh, make me, Lord, know that I am. Make me a piece in your master game plan. Free from the earthly temptation below, I've got the will, Lord, if you've got the toe. Dropkick me, Jesus, through the goalposts of life, in and over and through those righteous uprights, straight through the heart, neither left nor to right. Dropkick me, Jesus, through the goalposts of life. Take all the brothers who've gone on before, and all of the sisters who've knocked on your door, all the departed dear loved ones of mine, stick them up front, Lord, in the offensive line. Dropkick me, Jesus, through the goalposts of life, in and over and through those righteous uprights, straight through the heart, neither left nor to right. Dropkick me, Jesus, through the goalposts of life. A lowly bench warmer I'm contented to be, until the time, Lord, when you have need of me. Flash my name on that scoreboard that shines from on high, in the big Super Bowl way up there in the sky. Dropkick me, Jesus, through the goalposts of life, in over and through those righteous uprights, straight through the heart, neither left nor to right. Dropkick me, Jesus, through the goalposts of life. Dropkick me, Jesus, through the goalposts of life. Thank you. You know, I know a young married couple who just had their first baby, and he's a cutie, but they're really struggling with those 1 a.m. and 3 a.m. feedings and diaper changes. Yeah, you know, that's hard for young people. They ought to let us old people take care of new babies, because we're already up at those hours, you know. The only reason that might not be a good idea is we might forget where we laid the little booger, you know. Whoop, there's that music again. Time to turn the lights down, lock up the old cabaret one more time. We've enjoyed having you, and we hope you'll come back and see us next time here at Ray Stevens, that's me, Cabaret Nashville. So long, man. Madam. May I have this dance?
From Ray and the whole gang at CabaRay Nashville, I'm Bill Cody. So long till next time. Bye.
Come join us here at the CabaRay. That's the Ray Stevens CabaRay and Showroom right here in West Nashville. We're easy to find at the Charlotte Avenue exit off I-40 West. It's the place in Nashville for a special entertainment and dining experience. There's great food, all your favorite wines and mixed drinks, a fun piano bar where you can sing along and dance. And there's the Ray Stevens Show, where I'll sing all my biggest hits with Nashville's best musicians and singers. So whether it's a special date night, entertaining friends and family, or you're just coming out to sing along in the piano bar, whatever your reason, the CabaRay is a fun place to enjoy a full night of entertainment. And the parking is free. So come see me, Ray Stevens, at the CabaRay. Call 615-327-4630 or go to raystevenscabaret.com. Make your plans now.